Greetings, Seeker. Your contract is one Sasha Petroshenko. He is the boss of Siberia's largest criminal syndicate, the Yakutsk clan. They trade in drugs and weapons. And, as is common now, they're human traffickers too. Petroshenko was born in Moscow. There he rose from petty street criminal to influential crime boss. It was with Petroshenko's help that Nergui Kurchatov became Moscow's mayor. When Petroshenko was forced to flee the capital, it was Kurchatov, then Siberia's new governor, who allowed him to set up business in the Yakutia region. After the War of Independence, Petroshenko was given protection by the new Siberian government. He is now attempting to gain control of Western Siberia. These territories are run by his rival, Agvan Dorzhiev. It won't be easy, as Dorzhiev is also backed by the army. In an attempt to avoid all-out war, these two bosses have agreed to a private meeting at Petroshenko's dacha in the Beketov Valley. Inside the property are hidden video recordings that you must obtain. Agvan must also be killed. Then go to his nearby camp and retrieve information about his business operations. It will be useful to our employer. Finally, Petroshenko is preparing to execute a prisoner, his former deputy, Vladimir Romanovich. Free this man, and you will be richly rewarded. Stay focused, Seeker.
Huh, a peaceful spot.
There's too much of them. It would be best to avoid contact. Petroshenko is a wanted man. Isolation is his friend.
You're gonna tell me where the other soldiers are located.
Sure, I'll tell you. They're over there.
Seeker, we have hacked Petroshenko's laptop microphone. He is currently using a telecoms app. I'll patch you in.
They were stopped in Barnau, on your side, the Russian side. They took my girls, they put my men in prison.
Barnau? Yes. They have a new governor. He is not so cooperative. He wonders what it is that you, Sasha, bring to the table.
tell him that without my information and help, the Moscow Mafia would be running your fucking country.
Maybe. But the Moscow Mafia are almost finished now, which means you are becoming less and less useful to us.
That sounds like a threat.
It is a warning. To my bosses, you are just a small crime lord in a remote region of a foreign country.
Well, fuck you, Mikhail.
Dorzhiev has left his camp. ETA 90 seconds from you.
Getting a real good look at the big boss.
You know what to do. Dorzhiev has arrived.
I like it when my targets don't keep me waiting. That's a nice suit.
See that he is buried in it.
Are now marked on your map.
Target is dead.
He will not be mourned. As As always, I'll wait for an update from the exfiltration location.
Dorzhiev's dead.
I am sure he will be warmly welcomed in the underworld he's heading to. You can exfil now. Check your map for coordinates.
Charlie 50 to HQ. We had an explosion at our 20. Do you copy?
Well done. Proceed to the next one.
Men down! Shit!
You're gonna tell me where the other soldiers are located.
Sure, I'll tell you. They're over there.
Tell me where Romanovich is being kept.
He's in a cell. It's a container in the forest, at the base.
You are melting, Amy. Please, I am one of you. I am your good. You know who I am, I beg you. I was born in this province. You lock me up here.
It's like a home away from home. One way I know what you're here to do. But for freeing me, let me tell you, there is a hidden camera up at Zabarovka Dacha, behind the two-way mirror.
Perhaps what is filmed there would be useful.
Thanks. I'll remember that. He's free. For how long, I don't know.
Good work, Seeker. As always, I'll wait for an update from the exfiltration location.
You
data is secure. Job done.
Well done. Proceed to the next one.
I suppose Gulag prisoners once worked here.
Yes, they chained them to their tools. Wheelbarrows, pickaxes, spades, permanently attached to them.
Information about Dorzhiev's operations.
Oh, fuck! He keeps documents inside the cage, in the safe. Ugh.
got eyes on something.
Thank you.
the papers. I presume they contain everything you need.
Thank you, Seeger. As always, I'll wait for an update from the exfiltration location.
I suppose Gulag prisoners once worked here.
Yes, they chained them to their tools. Wheelbarrows, pickaxes, spades, permanently attached to them.